Ja, herzlich willkommen, meine sehr verehrten Damen und Herren. Welcome, everybody. I received lots of messages from, honestly, what I was very surprised of, all over the world that people are watching, and friends from Australia, from Mauritius, USA, and of course in Germany and Europe. And it's a big, big pleasure to have you now, in a way, virtually. Welcome, as I said, to my private studio, which has a new shape. It doesn't look like that usually, so it's we try to build it up like a stage for you, that also there's kind of this feeling also as a concert coming to you on the screen. And it's as I said, the very first time for me to do anything like this, and so I'm really hoping that everything works out technically, but I have the best support I can imagine. So already, thank you to Perfect Illusions, who provided me with all the technical equipment, and who are really, without them, it would not be possible to do this. So, it's quite sad, of course, that lots of my performances had to be cancelled because of this global situation that we are all facing at the moment. But especially we, as artists, of course, especially musicians, we are staying at home right now, as all of you. But of course, staying at home also means to be creative in a way. I spent the last weeks with composing a lot, and also I quite spontaneously thought, okay, so many performances and concerts were cancelled or had to be rescheduled, and so why not playing for you who are interested or would love to go to a concert? Just do it in this way with our modern media. And so I'm very happy that this opportunity exists. And yeah, so let's enjoy this live stream together. It's, for me, a privilege to do this, and exciting adventure, of course. At first, I played a marimba piece that I'm still working on at the moment. It was the fourth movement, and of Eric Samut, four rotations for marimba. And as second piece, you heard one of my favorite pieces for multi-percussion, the second part, the B part of Rebons von Yannis Xenakis. And next, I want to introduce a new instrument, the vibraphone. And let's continue with a song from Finland, which is also called Suominito. Thank you. So, after three pieces that were as composed as I played it, I'm coming for a completely quite new feel of mine that I'm working on at the moment. I started composing own pieces recently, and first of all, I started, of course, with only playing the drums. And that was when I was 3 years old. And of course, at the drums and the drum set especially, I, everything felt quite intuitive also over the years, more and more. And so after composing several pieces and own music on the drum set, now I try to make this feel a little bit bigger and also composed two setup pieces. And one of it had a very, very special event that I composed it for. It was about 6 weeks ago that I premiered this at the Beethoven House. And this is, of course, very special year to do this, and that for also a huge honor for me, because Beethoven would have been 250 years old this year. And at this anniversary occasion, there are lots of celebrations, of course, all over the world. At the moment, it's, of course, all of those wonderful concerts that should take place are also shut down. But this concert in February happened at Beethoven's birthplace. And it's based on Beethoven's Egmont Overture. And you will hear this right now in a short excerpt of an orchestra. Yeah, perhaps you noticed that this was not live, obviously. That was an orchestra excerpt, a recording of a wonderful concert that I was a part of. Maybe you also recognized the blonde kid on the timpani. That was me. Exactly 10 years ago, when I was 13 years old, I had the big pleasure to join the Bayerische Philharmonie on their tour through Korea. We had 9 concerts, and what you heard was our first concert in the Seoul Arts Center. And we played this Egmont Overture also before at the beginning of every of our 9 concerts there. And so this is why I had personally a quite close relationship already. And when the Beethoven Congress and Beethoven House asked me to write a percussion solo piece for our special concert that we had, where Jan Müller-Wieland wrote an arrangement of Beethoven's Egmont Overture, I tried to find something and create a piece with several colors of sounds in a known setup that I created. And for the Egmont Overture that we played in an arrangement, it was a septet. So we had 2 strings, we had 2 woodwinds and 2 brass instruments, and me as a percussionist. Which is also Stravinsky's formation of History of a Soldier. And so my setup was the base of Stravinsky's History of a Soldier, which was also the formation for the Egmont arrangement. And then I enlarged this setup with several sounds and also drums. So In the end now I'm using 11 drums combined with all kinds of metal sounds that I collected, but I'll tell you later on where they are coming from. For now, I'm thrilled and looking forward to play this for you. And when you want to hear the whole concert, still it's still available on the Deutschlandfunk. You just put in like Benning or Beethoven, whatever, and then you'll surely get to this concert. It was broadcasted on the 12th of February and still available, as I said. And then you can hear how my solo piece that I'm playing right now is combined also with the six other instruments. So what I'm playing now is not the original version, but the version of for solo, what I'm playing now.
Well, it's always, for me, of course, a new experience that I'm not very used to, playing my own music. And I enjoyed it, and I hope you did too. It was just the second performance ever of this piece. As I said, when you want to hear it in its full length, also with the formation of the added seven other musicians, I had six extraordinary colleagues that I was able to play with in February in the Beethoven House, then just go on, as I said, deutschlandfunk.de and feel free to listen to it. So, I mentioned already the metal sounds, which are definitely very unconventional. The only conventional metal sounds in a percussive way that I used was a triangle and a hi-hat and a cymbal. And all the others were collected by myself. When my former studio, which was placed and located in an old paper factory, when this whole factory area turned into a huge construction site, as it is teared down at the moment, I asked if I could, go there and search for metal gear to use for instruments. And now I really collected a huge number of several, all kinds of big metal forms and anything you can imagine. And what I placed here in this setup was just a small collection of it. And right at the moment, I'm also working on a quintet piece for five percussionists, obviously, where we are combining regular conventional drums and percussion instruments with these irregular or unconventional that I collected and searched and that I also used here. You maybe saw me when I hit this huge metal thing in front of me. That was when Egmont was cut off his head, which is sadly also his life story in a way. Next, as I said, I lost my old studio, but now I'm in my new studio, and I really very, very, very much like it. And so I think change is always also good for personal development. And of course, we are facing a very bad situation at the moment. But looking back to what was yesterday is important, but also looking to the future. And I think we should all stand together and be strong together and really stay home at the moment. And so that's why I did this concert. And also, just to flow back, though, to old days, in a way, where we could come together and joining, meeting each other with friends at concerts, whatever, sports events, just to get kind of this feeling back. I'll play a song for you, which you, I think, definitely know. And then I'll continue with my next thing where I put also some own stuff in it. Enjoy. Thank you. So, as I said, the next piece, well, first of all, I think you all recognize the piece, maybe. An old Beatles song yesterday. And as I said, soon it will be possible to get together again. And I'm already looking forward to it. And but of course, my deepest condolences to all who are, tragically infected, and also who still are suffering, and to because of this pandemic situation that never, no one of us, I think, ever expected. But of course, we should be positive, and I think it's important to just look forward, of course, to be able to join again in the future, and we'll make it through this hard time for all of us all over the world. So the next thing is a piece that I'm going to play is a snare drum piece that is written by a French composer, Dante Agostini, and I haven't played this for a while, but at this special occasion I wanted to do this because I recently created an own movie for this piece. It shows that percussion can also be program music. The title of the piece is Le Train. So it shows really an old train with a steaming engine and going very, very slowly, starting to move, running out of the station, through tunnels, over bridges, through several parts of landscapes, snow, wind, whatever. And in the end, it also comes back to the station and stops, obviously. And this is an old movie that I kind of... No, it's a new movie that I created, but out of very, very old movies that I stick together. So it's black and white only, and really those old trains that you will see right now. And I tried to put on the screen the images that I have in my head when I play this piece. As I said, going through the tunnel, making several dynamics in this piece, and just for you now to have this virtual train not only in your ear, but also in your eyes. You will see me playing it, and next to me on the screen you will see the movie that I tried to fix it, everything together. Enjoy. Thank you.
Can you see it? It's right here in front of me, right now. Watch. It's here. Can't you feel it?
Which is almost like a separate entity inside. Something which is almost like a separate entity inside.
I'm part of it. I'm. Can't you see it? You know what went through me? It passed right through me.
Expands beyond these moral characteristics and your concepts of right and wrong. It was like I was caught in something that I had no control over. I had absolutely no say-so as to what was happening.
But the guy I killed intended to kill me, so I killed him before he managed to kill me. He tried, but he failed miserably. Obviously, he's dead.
I can't tell you about it. If you can't see it, then you'll just never know it. Can you see it? It's right here in front of me, right now. Watch.
Someone else's eyes is far, far weirder than you think.
And the dimensions and all the prisms and the rays and everything coming down through you and moving. It's here. I'm part of it. Can't you see it? It passed right through. I would. I, I, can't see it, then you never know.
Yeah, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. First, we had this ride on the train, and I hope everybody arrived safely. And second, I just directly went into another piece, which is called Bad Touch. It also shows that percussion is not only playing with drums and any kinds of sounds or whatever to make it sound, but also a performance instrument. And this was a theatric piece where I just imitated all the sounds that you heard from the playback tape. So no sound was produced by myself, but I imitated all these rhythms and colors of sounds and beats that was put together by the composer Casey Cangolosi. And it's based on an interview that you hear the lady. She is initiated LSD for testing purposes, and that was like the interview after it. And the composer made a piece out of it, what I thought is great. And that was also to show you something different a little bit. And now, of course, I'm continuing with playing by myself again. Next piece is a soft one, a blues that is written for vibraphone solo. And it means a lot to me always. And of course, it's quite a sad time that we are facing at the moment. And this blues should not be against our motivation to defend this virus, but of course it maybe also helps us in an emotional way to think of those who got infected and also passed away because of it. And I'll play the blues for Gilbert now. Yeah, usually in my concerts, I'm playing this piece when I play with my percussion group, what I love to do always. Then we usually play this piece in a trio version, so accompanied by a drum set and a bass. And like all our planned concerts for the next month and also the recent weeks were cancelled, of course, and I'm very much hoping to be back on stage with my guys. When I came back from New York like 3 weeks ago from my concerts in the USA, then I had the chance to record with my percussion group, and we spent a few days together in a great concert hall in Munich. And because we are not able to play concerts for you at the moment, I want to show you a small image and video excerpt of our recordings. There will be a lot of videos coming up soon, also from our concert and my solo debut at the Elbphilharmonie in Hamburg, on YouTube and on my homepage as well. But for now, just for you, what you can expect and also what you miss at the moment because we're not able to play together, but hopefully soon back on stage and concerts again. Now for you, our recorded C minor preludium from Johann Sebastian Bach. Yeah, I used this little break for me right now at the moment to set up a little bit. And yes, as I said, I hope you enjoyed this small excerpt of our recordings. Soon there will be a lot of videos posted. And I can't wait to be back together with my teammates, let's call it so, Patrick Stapleton, Marcel Morikawa, Felix Kolb and Severin Schitzenberger. And as I said, I have to play alone, on my own today, but my partners from Meinl Cymbals and Percussion, over the recent weeks, because of the situation, every kind of artist is also forced to stay at home, they put some playbacks and backing tracks on their homepage, and I think that's a really, really great idea. So percussionists all over the world are able to share what they are doing with the same backing tracks, kind of playback tapes, as I said, and everyone does something different. And as I think that's such a great initiative, I wanted to do and put it in my repertoire today as well. There's a backing track that you can all check out and feel free on the Meinl Percussion homepage to play to it as well, which is called Sun Rays. And I will play that a few times in a loop in a way, and playing it on the percussion instruments and then moving to the drum set. And then I continue with a known solo that I just wrote last night in a way, put it on this, trying to make it fit together with the sun rays. And I hope you will like it. And it's definitely the first time that I'm doing kind of a complete run through. And so I hope everything goes well. And so just, enjoy. And as I said, feel free and check out not only the wonderful products on cymbals and percussion instruments at Meinl, but also, of course, the backing tracks that can put us all together, of course, as well. Thank you. Well, that was fun for me. Hope you liked it as well. As I said, just whether you're a percussionist or not, just feel free. Check out the great products of Miles Simonson Percussion and check out their backing tracks. It's something that we can use also to get together. And thank you, of course, for the support at Meinl from my side, of course. Also, thank you to Studio 49, which is my partner company for my mallet instruments, the vibraphone that you heard before, and the marimba, what you will hear now. And I'm very looking forward, of course, also to our upcoming and further cooperation and collaboration. As I said, this next piece is for the marimba, written by Isaac Albéniz, a very famous Spanish composer, born in 1860. And he wrote, as an homage to his home country, Spain, the so-called Suite Española. It has 8 numbers or movements, and I did an arrangement of the 5th one, which is probably the most known one, but not for piano as it is the original version, but for Spanish guitar. And this was transcribed by Andres Segovia, and I used this also as my kind of secondary literature to adopt and transcribe this for my marimba, as I'm not a very good pianist and not playing the guitar at all, but I wanted to play this piece so much, and so I wrote my own arrangement, and it's a pleasure to play it for you now. Asturias by Isaac Albéniz, arranged by myself. Thank you. Well, we are, already coming to the end of this concert in a way. As I said, it was absolutely an adventure for me, and I really appreciated that I got such a big support by Perfect Illusions. It would not be not possible to do all that without their support, and so thank you. And I'm looking forward to all our other projects that are coming. Upcoming projects, that's the right word right now. Before, you will hear also three excerpts of my percussion group, of our recent concert at the Elbphilharmonie in Hamburg. I want to let you know, of course, check out the dates on my homepage, and we would love, of course, to be able to welcome you again in our concerts. Like the what is planned next is still at the 30th of June in the Brunnenhof of the Munich Royal Residence. It will be an open air concert, and so this would be, of course, great that have it to happen, of course, but we will see how everything develops and how the situation goes on. Most important, of course, is that we all over the world will find a way to defeat this virus, and we can only do this together, of course. And so every concert that has to be cancelled is just an absolutely necessary decision to be taken. And so just check out the dates, and you will find them up to date very soon. And as I said, now you will see a few excerpts of our Elbphilharmonie concert, and hope you will enjoy it. And then you can decide if you want to check out our concert upcoming, if you want to get some tickets. We would love, of course, to have you there. And so thank you again, especially, of course, Studio 49 and Meinl Simbers and Percussion. And we'll, start the recording, and you will see my guys playing and being with me on stage. Thank you. Thank you. So what you heard was, first of all, a trio piece, Trio per Uno. Then you heard John Cage's Third Construction. And finally, at the third excerpt, Beethoven's Moonlight Sonata that we play at the moment. And also, you heard the third movement in this year of Beethoven, of course, 250 years, it's his anniversary. We wanted to try to put our instruments into his music or implement his music for our formation, of course. And this is, what we are trying out this year. And you will hear some more Beethoven throughout the year, hopefully, and when you come to our concerts. So just check out on Instagram, on Facebook, and also on my homepage, YouTube. There will be a lot of more videos coming in the next few days. I'm very looking forward. If you have the feeling to donate something for today, you'll find a PayPal link as well, but you don't have to. This was just, for me, as I said, a trial and an adventure. My first live stream concert that I organized on my own. I did it a few times, but not with having all the responsibility for everything, playing and the technic stuff. So I hope that you heard everything and that you saw everything. It was a big privilege to have you here in my studio virtually, and hope to see every one of you very, very soon in person. Thanks for watching. Thanks for your attention. Stay healthy. Also, stay at home, of course, for the next few weeks. But then I think every one of us is very, very much looking forward to get together again. And see you soon. Take care and have a good night. In Germany, lots of people will continue now with the Tatort, I think. And so I'll continue now not with Tatort, but with Tornado. This is my last piece that I'm playing right now. And I hope you like it. Thank you for your attention, and bye. See you soon.